Good morning, everyone. It's April and Lynne. We're walking down Main Street, and we're in Universal Orlando. So excited. Thank you, Universal Orlando, for visiting us, allowing us to visit, and having us out. And this is my first time seeing the holidays in Universal Orlando. So we're going to see everything, and I'm going to show you all the details. So hang in, but the holidays are here. Alright, we are in the gate and we are walking around Universal Studios. It does seem like it's going to be a little bit busier of a day today. The parks are not at 100% capacity, so busy is a really relative term. It's not pre-COVID busy. It's just COVID busier. So there's Minion Mayhem, Despicable Me, and that's already at a 50-minute wait. That is a motion ride. If anyone has motion sickness worries about Universal, ask me questions. I can't ride several of the rides because I do get motion sick. I can't do coasters, spinning, or motion rides. So if you have questions, ask me. I can tell you. Shrek 4D, that's a really cute show. It is a little dated, but it is a really cute show. And for the Despicable Me ride, there actually is a stationary vehicle. So it's a motion ride, but the vehicles move to the motion of the movie. So there is a place where you can sit that doesn't move. And so I just have to close my eyes on some of the motion parts that would be upsetting or, you know, would make me sick. So we're gonna show you all the holiday things. We're gonna check out the tribute store. Definitely gonna see the Macy's holiday floats. Lynne and I acquired a friend today. Our friend Cheryl is with us. So we'll show you her too. I know, I'm gonna spin it around. So and our friend Cheryl is trying to avoid the camera. There she goes.
It's pretty busy here today.
So,
can't wait for all this to have the entire.
Oh, there's the holiday experience. So we should head over to the balloons and see what time they open.
The Macy's Day balloon.
I know the park just opened at 9 for the Halloween Horror Nights houses last month. They did, or actually October, it's December now. Even though the park opened at 9, the houses did not open until 10. I don't know the timing for this, but we're gonna go find out. Because we need to see this.
No, definitely, I'm never gonna.
And the Christmas tree, I'm so excited for this. So pretty. And then in the tree, they always have a hidden squirrel. And I can't remember the squirrel's name, but they did, at one point, the story was something to, they put up the Christmas tree, and there was a squirrel that kept chewing the wires, and it took them a little bit to figure out why the lights would be out. And then they found the squirrel. So now, every year, they put a squirrel in the tree in memory of him. And I'll add in his name, because I don't remember the squirrel's name. So here is a balloon experience. Oh, wait time, 5 minutes. We are doing this.
Yay!
So excited! Everybody's running to the rides.
That's okay, they can do this.
I know, this is perfect. Oh, there's Rip Ride Rocket. That is one of the rides that
I
will never ride.
Good
morning, thank you.
Just for us, right?
I knew we were coming.
We appreciate you.
Here we go. See Rip Ride Rocket as we're passing by. And it goes up and around. My son loves the ride. And they're actually, they does play music, and there is a secret song list on the ride. You have to push certain buttons, like for the first 30 seconds you sit down, and then you get to, I think, select a song. So, interesting. Here we go. Good morning. Oh, this is so exciting. Oh. Good morning. So I've never seen their holiday parade, but because of COVID, they want to still give it to people so you can feel safe and yet see all of the floats.
Ladies and gentlemen,
and balloons.
May I have your attention, please?
How awesome is this? Photographer for Santa, with Santa, so you do need to take selfies. Important note. There's a toy soldier. And here's Santa's sleigh. I just love this so much. I mean, I would definitely have loved to have seen the parade next year. Next year we'll get to the parade, but this is next best thing. So kudos to Universal for giving a nice safe option for people to feel like you still get the holiday experience, you're not missing out. So pretty. All right, we're just finishing the experience and you walk out and it's snowing. I don't know if you can tell on the camera. It is cool here in Florida today, so not quite snow weather because it is blue skies and nice and sunny, but it has little flurries coming down. There you might be able to see the snow. There, yep, we got that on camera. So, honestly, this is kind of the only snow I like. I'm really kind of over the wet snow from home. All right, more to come. We love seeing the balloons. I just think that was such a great idea. Now we're gonna show you the Christmas tree. Important sign, facial coverings to be worn at all times, and it does have to be double layer masks. No gaiters are allowed, no bandanas as previously were allowed. While you're eating or drinking, you can take off your mask. However, when you're taking a picture, you are allowed to do a mask-free picture, and that is unusual. Disney does not allow that. Universal, you are allowed to take your mask off to take a picture and get a nice picture with your family that way. So we did do a picture when we came in and social distance. Oh, and there's the panda. awesome. Universal is also doing a great job with characters. They're always out everywhere. Again, they're social distanced. You're not hugging them. You can't get autographs. But you are seeing the panda. You are seeing the characters. You're going to see them all. So that's a nice thing. I love the Santa hats on the light posts. It's so cute. And you can see the buildings are decorated. Jimmy Fallon's is decorated. And here's our Christmas tree. So when you come here, you have to see if you can find the squirrel, if he's in there. And the tribute store, we're definitely going in there, so we're going to show you that. And they have the Macy's store, which I love. So I've always been from New England. I've never been to New York for Thanksgiving, so that is a bucket list thing for me. I know this year they didn't allow any spectators, but they did still have at least the parade go through. So it was different, COVID friendly, but I want to go someday when it's safe.
I was going to give Jill one.
Oh, okay.
So let's... Absolutely, we are going in the tribute store.
Tribute and I thought that was it. So
nope.
I'm like, why is she not going over to the tribute store?
Yep. Good morning. Thank you.
We appreciate you.
So this is the store they use for Halloween Horror Nights, which I did show that in my previous video for visiting Universal, and now it's converted to everything holiday. Oh, it's so sweet with all the toys. Sorry if I'm panning this too fast. This is a brand new camera, so I'm getting used to it. So please bear with me and forgive me. Oh, how sweet is this? How pretty. And it amazes me the effort they put into these stores, because I mean, it is a store, so there's lots of things to buy here. But it is decorated floor to ceiling with theming. Oh, now they have a wax Santa. They had a wax Frankenstein and a wax jack-o'-lantern for Halloween Horror Nights. And now you can get a wax Santa to make. Lots of ornaments, of course. Love it. And this is so sweet. Everything themed, E.T. We loved E.T. growing up. My brother, who's 6 years younger than me, he had an E.T. stuffed animal, and I actually still have that. It's probably seen better days, but I'm very nostalgic and sentimental with things, so it's tough to get rid of old things like that. Room. Thing one and thing two. I told this story before that my kids were thing one and thing two when they were little. I think my son was like two when we did it, and I even made them wear the blue wigs. So I still think about that. There you can get a wax snowman. I love that. The mugs are cute, and I love the fireplace with the stockings. Cindy Lou's stocking, and you can make your own and they'll personalize them. So another little extra thing to commemorate your trip and remember your Christmas in Universal Orlando. queen of naughty. Well, sometimes when you have naughty kids, I would consider myself the queen of naughty. Although my kids are really good. I'm very blessed. And love this. So then the hall for Halloween Horror Nights, this was all the old HHN posters. And now it's all Christmas tributes. This is really fun. Here's where they're doing embroidery. So look, you can get even Harry Potter scarves embroidered. What a great gift for someone. You have a Harry Potter fan? You can get them their house color scarf. Harry Potter stockings embroidered. Love this. I'm not a huge Harry Potter fan, but I absolutely can appreciate it for what it is. And the lands, Diagon Alley, is amazing. We will definitely show you Diagon Alley because, oh my goodness. If you are a Harry Potter fan, you have to come here. I know my cousins came here and they're huge Harry Potter fans and they cried when they saw it, just because you literally are stepping into the books. The details are unbelievable. Thank you. Earl the Squirrel. That's what it is. That's Earl that's in the tree. How fun are those Earl the Squirrel ornaments? I kind of love that. Can you see? I don't know if I'm showing you them. And I don't have my reading glasses on, so I honestly can't tell you how much that is. But that's what it is. He's Earl the Squirrel in the tree. Oh, and here we are. Earl the Squirrel's tree home. Love that. All right, and here's our weakness. Oh, now they've got a red velvet candy cane pop. So we did the red velvet pop, cake pop for Halloween Horror Nights. Sugar cookie trees, gingerbread whoopie pies, orange peppermint mousse. Amazing. This is Holiday Gummy Lights. Butterscotch, peppermint, and cinnamon. Wow. That's really interesting. So you get hot chocolate, or it looks like an eggnog. Earl's Nutty Nog. I'm assuming is an eggnog. Or you can get sticky buns. Oh, and Cheryl is indulging. And that's the end of the tribute store. So it's hot cocoa, and that's a chocolate bomb.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness! You got someone right behind you that wants to come through.
It's making a mess on me, though. It's
she is making a mess.
It's fluid.
You got the ornament from the cold case?
No, she just gave it to me.
Okay. Yeah, so it melts as you go and
it
keeps
evolving.
Oh, wow.
Okay, we'll clean that up for you. No worries.
It's really, look at it. It's
wow. That's amazing. As we head out, so Cheryl did get one of the hot chocolates. It's an Italian hot chocolate with a chocolate ornament bomb that's filled with marshmallows. So as the chocolate melts the chocolate ornament bomb, it opens up to this huge pile of marshmallows. So much fun. I just want to show you, there is Earl the Squirrel. He's got a little mask on and he's going back into his hole now.
She becomes very responsible.
Absolutely, as squirrels would be.
I'm so impressed with him.
They have to be safe too.
Great thing you had to say. Their character.
How cute is he? We saw Earl the Squirrel. Is a motion ride, and from what I understand, it's pretty intense. A lot of people I've spoken to who like rides have said that they have felt sick getting off of it. Men in Black is a really cute ride, and it's one that I'm disappointed that I can't ride because it's a target game. So you're shooting at the aliens and you get points, and it's pretty, well, I would say fairly easy to get some higher point things. But the cars spin, and you can actually shoot each other's cars, and then that will make your vehicle spin. So when I rode it, the other team apparently had really good aim, and we were getting killed, and it was just constantly spinning, and that was not a good thing for me. And you can get Duff beer here. Of course, there's the Quickie Mart, Cletus's Chicken Shack, and Moe's. I don't know if those are open right now. And Jebediah Springfield statue. There's the DeLorean from Back to the Future, and the train from Back to the Future 3. And you can see Doc Brown. We did get to see him in July when we were here. I think it was July. I've never seen them have Marty, so I don't know if they do Marty McFly here, but you can do the meet and greet with Doc Brown. And there's always surprise characters out, so here's the Mystery Machine with Scooby-Doo and friends. You can come see them. Again, everything is social distance, so social distance pictures, no autographs, no hugs. I know I've seen them here before. They come out and they do like a little routine, and then they take pictures with any guests that want them. So it's fun. And we've almost done a complete circle now of the park. And now we've made it to Hollywood. So that's the entrance where the parade floats would come out. But again, that's not happening right now. The Monster Makeup Show, highly recommend that. It's a really good show, really funny. And up here's the Simpsons RV.
And here.
So Mel's driving is fun.
And I mean those two.
That's good food. Last time we went, it was a really long wait, but it was good food. And it's really cute inside because it's like a 50s diner.
Hey, how are you?
Oh, and there's Bart. And then if you are an annual pass holder, they do have the annual pass holder lounge in here where you can come in, you can sit, you can charge, there's outlets, they have pass holder merchandise, and you can get free monthly buttons and sometimes magnets. I'll give you just a quick overview of what the lounge looks like. If you are going to come to Universal more than once, it is very worth it to consider an annual pass. Economically, it works out. You have access, park-to-park access, both parks. You can get a three park, which includes Volcano Bay, which is closed right now till March. You need to do Volcano Bay. It is amazing. So there's seating in here. There are outlets. So you can come in, charge your phone. It's air conditioned when it's nice and toasty out. And they do have annual pass holder specific merchandise. You can come in, get a refreshment. The Cokes are for purchase, they're not for free, but you can come in and do that. And again, they do have the monthly pins and occasional monthly magnets for annual pass holders, so well worth checking out. Thank you, have a good day. Born Spectacular, you need to do it. It's so good. This was really good. We got to see this in July when it just opened. And it's so creative how they do it. Overview of Hollywood. Oh, here comes the Madagascar float. There, can you see Madagascar in the distance? And it's all decorated for Christmas. You got the stars, Jerry Lewis. Oh.
Have yourself.
Okay. Hello. Yes, please. Thank you. And for the shows, seating is every other row, so they do keep you social distanced so you can feel safe. Honestly, we have not had any issues with feeling compromised at any point in the parks. I mean, everybody needs to make their own decisions, you know, as far as your own particular health situation and what you're comfortable with. But I think it's been very well done. As you can see, the floors are clearly marked, and most of the time people do follow them. I have to catch myself though, because I don't think my brain has allowed me to let the COVID stuff sink in, that it's just so craving normalcy that it's like, oh, you take for granted you can just walk in and stand where you want to stand. And it's like, nope, you need to stay with the line. So I do make a conscious effort to make sure that I'm doing what I can. But can't wait for the day when you can just go and stand wherever the heck you want. The Born Stuntacular is such an amazing show. Oh my God, you need to see it. We're ending our visit on the highlight of seeing that show, so we're getting ready to leave the park now. So that was our day in Universal Orlando. Hope you had fun seeing all the Christmas decorations and the Christmas balloons. Love the Macy's balloons. They are amazing, and it was really nice to be able to see them. We are going to be showing you more Christmas over in Islands of Adventure, but so be sure to check into the next vlog. And appreciate it if you like, share, subscribe the channel, tell your friends. We really want to build this up and we need your help. So please let us know and be sure to leave a comment. Have a great day.